Welcome. My name is Evelyn and this is Patsy.
What's going on?
We're gonna give you some advice on the tracks that we recently received. So as per usual, we play 5 tracks and we also give you some feedback. So if you have any comments in regards to the tracks you're gonna hear, you can put your comments down below. DVRKCLOUD and this track's name is Cold Voices. So yeah, what are your thoughts?
It's definitely good musicianship on like the breakdown. Drop could have been like a little bit more like harder, aggressive. Maybe it wasn't mastered right. But it was definitely a cool sound.
I like the sound too. I feel like it was like very kind of like chill and ambient, and it was like progressive at moments. But yeah, I agree. Like, I was expecting something and I didn't get surprised. But this is definitely a really good track that can go up on like Majestic Casual or Mr. Suicide Sheep. These are the platforms that post similar music. So definitely like made me relax. I don't know, did you feel relaxed?
Yeah, it was very chill. It was a good vibe.
I think like the artwork that I saw on this track was like very like, it had like this nature element to it. So I feel like you definitely know what you're doing with your music, you understand it. Because you know that this is maybe a good song for like, you know, traveling or hiking, and it's like very ambient vibe, so yeah, I liked it.
A little snare hit before the drop might help you too, because I was waiting for that and I didn't hear it.
Yeah, a little electric shock.
Futurise. Zaxtro.
Not sure. But I get what you're trying to do. Little like Dutch house.
Yeah, that's future house. That type of sound.
Yeah, I think like a lot of producers from Holland make that kind of music. Like Quantino, you should definitely like look into Quantino. He's quite big in Europe. You know, he also plays in the US.
A lot of DJs are going in the future house direction. Even like Tiesto is doing future house. That's pretty much the way to go now, because big room is kind of fading out, so a lot of people are doing the sound. I see where you're trying to go. I think the synth or your bass line and the drop is a little loud, so if you want to like lower it, that would it'd probably be a little bit better. Maybe put a side chain or something on it so it doesn't stick out as much, and you get a little bit more out of the kicks too.
Yeah, future house, but to me like a little raspy, you know. It's like future house that has a cold So I feel, you know, a lot of future house tracks are smoother. Mm-hmm. Go follow Quantino. Look into those, you know, Dutch superstars. They make similar music, definitely in direction.
Follow the leader. I always say that.
Always follow the best one in the industry, and that's how you're gonna become better eventually when they retire. Mm-hmm. Or maybe sooner. We don't know, but.
Yep.
All right. Let's move on to the next one.
All right.
What's the name of it?
This one here.
So Gary Franks and Matt Staring Eyes, or Staring.
Staring. I can see what he was trying to do with that. That's cool. That's like techno.
Yeah, it is techno. Yeah, for sure.
That's real underground. But a lot of the sounds you were using were like very stock, very like cheap. I see what you were trying to do. It was cool. I like the way that your use of the vocal, the little sample that you did. That was cool. I just recommend layering your sound so you don't have like a very like stock, cheap sounding like synths and like bass lines and stuff like that. You can go for like the whole 808 sound and stuff too. That's cool, but also pump up your mastering a little bit too, because your wave has a little bit of has a little headroom. You can definitely use to pump it up a little bit.
Yeah, I like also what you do with this track. Anyway, there is a DJ duo. Their name is Solardo, and there is actually a track that has like a similar vibe to it. In terms of quality, I feel like perhaps on a you know, slightly higher level, and they might have like 500,000 streams at the moment, but it's called On the Corner. And the channel actually sort of posts their music is called Sub Soul. So this is something you should definitely look into and see, you know, if you make that kind of music and you work on it, you could send the music to them. I think that would be definitely a match. But yeah, overall, techno vibes. I'm from Europe, so shout out the Europeans. You know, techno is very big out there. Not something that I'm so passionate about, but I still like it and enjoy it when it's done well. So, as he said, like, need some work, but keep it up. Don't give up.
No, it's cool German techno. It sounds a very German sound.
Yeah, it's does cool. have that vibe. Mm-hmm. But yeah, what's our next one?
So our next track is going to be Reborn, R3BRN, looks like.
Okay, Reborn.
Yep.
The next fear. Here. Wanna dance with me? What's your dance move?
I just kinda do this.
Alright, we're just gonna do this.
Well, I used to do this back in the day. Thank you. underground. There's not much to it though. They could have.
It's like deep house-ish. Yeah.
It's definitely a little. It's definitely on the deep house side. It could have used
what's
some more.
This guy?
Some more sounds.
More sounds. Okay, I wouldn't say more sounds, but maybe you're right. I would say more vocals or vocals in general.
No, I think that would definitely be a good track for a vocal if you can.
This track is great for a vocal. This track would like just literally be so different. Like I feel like the vocals would like uplift it. You know,
definitely.
Like very like uplifting vocals would lift it up. Basically, that's what I mean.
Yeah.
But yeah, Marcus Caballero is like a deep house artist that makes similar music, but I feel like he does at the vocals, and not even like at the intro or like before the drop, it could be like after the drop, and, like, you know, spoil them with the sounds, but then like also throw some like, you know, nice uplifting vocals on it, so that way you just like don't feel so bored, you know.
I agree with that. You can definitely, that's a perfect track for vocals. It has a nice like bass line drop and stuff, so a lot of that
is
sound.
There anything else you would change about it?
I mean, it was cool. There's not much I would change. I would maybe, you know, the bass line sounds a little cheap. I mean, I'm kind of like, I'm into like layering and stuff.
He's
like
all
that.
About that money, you know, that expensive
cheap.
Bass line.
It doesn't have to. You actually don't need money for sounds. You just need to layer them, and you know, instead of just having one sound, you have like six or seven combined. And you'll
layer
get
the hundreds and then send them over. And then he's gonna do the bass line for you.
You'll get
he
a
was
nice,
never dreamt of.
You get a nice sound if you start laying a little bit more. That's cool. Yeah, definitely work on a vocal for that one. Alright,
okay.
So we got one more. This is
last
be...
one. What's the name?
This is Shatter Machine Boo. Cool name.
Okay. This was some sort of monster ball. I think like I would call like Lady Gaga and see if she likes it. But I know you're enjoying yourself here, so you know, I don't want to get in there. Somebody I would suggest you to follow is like your style, like in between like computers, meaning Skrillex and Seven Lions, which is like more metal. Like definitely that falls into like that metal step category, and there is actually a channel for it on YouTube you should send the music to called Raindex, and they do have a lot of those artists making, you know, sort of dance music like dubstep in this case that has those like rock and like metal influences, which I'm like all up for because this is something unique and, you know, finding your sound despite the fact we tell you to like follow this artist and that artist, the most important thing in a world is to find yourself and follow yourself and find your own sound. So, you know, I'm not the biggest fan of this track, but hey, let's give it up for Patsy.
The track is dope. I like it. It's typical dubstep. It's a typical dubstep sound. But I urge everyone, please get your tracks mastered. Once this fire engine passes by, you can get your tracks mastered. No, really, that's really important. You're gonna hear a big difference if you get it professionally mastered. You can probably do it for like $150 somewhere. I mean, that's really important. It really brings out your sounds. Like this was great, but like, the breakdown was really like low as opposed to like the drop. So like, I would have to adjust the levels in the middle of the track, and like stuff like that really makes a difference when you're when you want everything to be heard in your song. But it was definitely cool. I liked the whole movie vibe and stuff like that. So, definitely mostly focus on the mastering. Other than that, maybe listen to like Slushy or somebody like in that area, like Skrillex also in Seven Lines. Definitely just do what they do. I mean, you don't want to be exactly like them, but definitely take a lot from what they do. I can definitely tell you they're on the right track.
Yeah, their bank accounts are on the right track.
Oh, yeah.
But for real, we always like look for more music, new music. We're trying to connect you guys wherever we can. And if you have more music for us and you want to share something that you just made and you just want like a second opinion and you're not afraid to be getting real feedback, then send it over. Like and subscribe and like and subscribe. Thank you for tuning in.
Later.
See you later, alligator producers. Mr. Ball is over.